So we've got one of our acolyte hybrids here. I'm gonna start with the legs. I'm trying to figure out, when do his pants even end? I think they've got kind of a cuff thing going on, and then from that cuff down, it's like bare hybrid legs. So let's roll with that instinct. That's 11 foot. All right, looks like that arm pair that's holding the drill is purely a Genestealer arm, so I can just rock that out in the green. There we go. That's progress. Crook of the arm, hand, nice lively green color. Alright, let's do the brace arm. Alright, so there's one all greened up. This guy's going to be easier as his... There we go. Is there a pant cuff? There's definitely a cuff. There's definitely a cutoff point that I can see there. So let's slap some paint there. Tells me a clog is forming. Thank you. looks good. Face, I guess. We are on the face, aren't we? There's two. I think I should move them outside as I get them done. Okay. I want to finish all of the acolytes before I move on to the abominants, I think. Oh, yeah. Got some beef. Okay. Down. Keep chugging. Okay. So here's my munitioner. Demolitionist model here. Note that I went with the most comical of the two different arms holding explosives set. Thank you. I shall need to clean my noodle after this round, I think. It's gobbing up all weird. Another model, all greened up. Or at least the first level of green. There's much more green to be done once we are beyond that point. For now, this is where we're at. Ooh, look at all that. Unbroken skin area. Abominance. These guys can take a ton. Got a little bit of Hulk smash going on here. These base colors are just so much faster to do with an airbrush. It would take me so long to get all the skin up to this green color with a traditional brush, and here I'm just knocking them out of the park one at a time. Boom. Another one. Done enough. That's the magic words. Done enough. Doesn't have to be perfect. Doesn't have to be my best work. It just has to be enough color on it so that when I make a pass with a brush, I'm able to clean it up and apply a wash and apply highlights and then be done. This guy's got quite a back. He's gonna need some, he's the hypermorph. Yeah, he's gonna need some special some special attention, that's for sure. There. I'm not sure how much pant, how much skin there is, so I'm trying to be careful with it, but honestly pretty hard to figure out where one texture ends and the other begins. This is where it gets wild, right? The bone is gonna be brown. Those bridges there are gonna be green. Hence my dilemma. Turn the speed way down and put the brown on him. Here's where it gets fun. I still have plenty of green on my palette here. I think what I may do is just race to the finish. Grab a handful of neophytes and see how much skin I can get on the game here. There appears to be still one more to go. Let's see how much skin is on these neophytes. Let's give it a shot. Doesn't seem to step on anything too important. Just a pin. Alright. Got one more power hammer guy to finish up. Move on to neophytes. Managed to get a drop of neon green paint on my shoelace. Do I have a clock for me? Do appear to have a clog forming. That is worth trying to fix. Now we'll get to the bottom of this with some cleaner. Quick disassembly while I unclog my brush here. Yeah, I think I may have solved my clog problem. I hope I have, at least. Because when that happens, it's terribly inconvenient. Clogs as a kind of shoe are hilarious, but when your airbrush clogs, that leads to suffering. Tension nice and high. Let's run a little water through it to get the cleaner out. There we go. All right. Back to it. Got more of this lime-colored paint to apply. That's better. That's much limier. That's much better. Oh, yeah. Doesn't look that other foot is visible. What the hell? Is there a whole leg missing from this model? I may have missed an entire leg on this guy. Well, that's going to be embarrassing to paint separately. Huh. Alright. Learn something every day, am I right? Okay, some neophytes. And we've got some exposed arm. Looking nice and limey. Some AdMech models that I've converted to proper neophyte cultists there. Took me long enough to unclog this bad boy. Alright, I see gloves, but I've got an exposed head that I can throw green on. Better. Oops.
That'll show me for underusing the tack on the base there. Let's try that again, but with a thicker concentration of it.
That's better.
Those arms don't really line up at all, do they? I may have to paint that to be a battle injury. We're done with that part of the green, fortunately. I was reaching a point where it was starting to jam up my brush big time.
Next up is that liverly green color. Now, I don't plan on palleting or reservoiring that, so that should be a little easier. Which is good, because I'm beginning to run out of time. I've got about 15 good minutes left before I've got to be on the move. So, with that in mind, let me hustle and get this green on the road. So, we're moving on to the liverly green again. This time for the rank and file. Supposed to be more of a highlight color. So let's see if I can accomplish that, huh? Many more to go. Oh, this guy didn't get the regular green on his head. Gotta save him for later, won't I? That guy, there we go. Mr. Clearly missing a leg here. Adding highlights to the skin part of the hypermorph next. Alright, we're gonna flush this because there's a model who I missed the previous green on. I need to go back and finish that guy up before I move on to the next. Okay. Stirring up a little more of the scorpion green for the demolitions. There may be a clog, so let's flush this more thoroughly now. What's my time looking like? Okay. Still got about 10 minutes. Should be enough time to apply yellow to the remaining view there. Deliberately green again. Determined to finish these guys up before I hit the road. And we're off. That's about right. We got the drill guy here.
It's about that. Alright, apart from the demos guy, we are now back to Neophytes. It's appropriate that my combined neophyte hybrid admic guys are basically green Martians. You know, because Mars, get it? Martians. Alright, I tried. Set of hands that are just gonna have to be gloves, huh? Guess I can get them yelling, justify it. Perhaps. That'll have to do. Not ideal. Oh man, here too? Ah! Just making these spools so non-stick, huh? Right. That's my cue to do something different with those. Because that's clearly not working anymore. Guy's definitely got gloves. But this guy. Taking a look. Glove. Yeah, okay. Alright, so some of these models do definitely have gloves on, but not all of them. Alright, so that just about wraps up. Go ahead and purge this here. And clean up my airbrush. And we're just about done.